Edward Gough Whitlam was one of the dominant figures of Australian public life in the 20th century. His election as Prime Minister in December 1972 brought to an end 23 years of Conservative rule and ushered in the most tumultuous political period since Federation. In just 3 years, Whitlam's government ended our involvement in the Vietnam War, abolished conscription, opened up diplomatic relations with Communist China, introduced universal national health care, the country's first ever consumer protection and trade practices laws, and equal pay for women. But Whitlam's social revolution coincided with the first oil shock, which devastated Western economies. His government was economically inept and also beset by scandals, most notably the Khemlani loans affair, which forced the sacking of senior ministers Rex Connor and Jim Cairns.
There will now be an election.
With the public turning against Whitlam, Malcolm Fraser's opposition blocked supply in the Senate. Unable to govern, his administration was sacked by the most controversial Governor-General in our history, Sir John Kerr.
Well, may we say, God save the Queen. Because nothing will save the Governor-General.
Gough called on supporters to maintain the rage, but the voters sided with the Governor-General, and his government was gone in a landslide. Another devastating defeat in 1977 prompted Gough to announce his retirement from politics, but he spent the rest of his life defending his government and railing against the dismissal.
A day that will live in infamy.
It wasn't the end of his public life, though, as he later served as ambassador to UNESCO and even made up with Malcolm Fraser to defend media diversity and to campaign for a republic.
It's time.
At his side throughout his entire public life was his wife of more than 65 years, Margaret. Their lifelong partnership was acknowledged in 2007 when they were jointly honoured as the first ever National Life members of the Australian Labor Party.